نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. الله سبحانه وتعالى loves his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam the most out of all his creation, to the point that he mentions in Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. Indeed, Allah and the angels send salutation upon Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. O you who believe, you send the salutation and blessings upon Rasulullah as well. From this command, one would understand that this is an obligation for the believers to say so. To fulfill an obligation is meritorious and is a praiseworthy action. Now, one can add on that as much as one likes, especially when Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encourages us to do so. And Durood Sharif is actually a dua from the believers. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we beseech Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send his blessings upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Obviously Allah would do that anyway. And that is why this is something that Allah loves from most of the things that he would love. And this is the top one out of those. And that is why when someone does it, we are fulfilling the wish of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentioned in Quran, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. O my messenger, these pagans, these idolaters of Makkah used to mock you, and they said that we will leave you, we have abandoned you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O my beloved. They call you Abtar, the one who would never be remembered, the one who wouldn't have any children, and his lineage would be cut off, so he wouldn't be remembered at all after he passed away. We will make you the most known person in the history, the one who would be remembered by many, many people at the same time, the one who would be remembered and loved by the most. And there's no doubt about that. No one has been ever mentioned from amongst the creation more than Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So actually, we are, by saying durood upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we are pleasing Allah. We are fulfilling the wish of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that whoever does that in abundance, they are actually getting me to do an intercession on the Day of Judgment after Adhan, for example, and then the Dua of Adhan. They all have blessings included within those zikrs. So Durood Sharif is something that is a Dua, and these du'as are accepted regardless, because this is what Allah asked us to do. Allah will send salutation, as the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam confirms that whoever sends one blessings upon Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would increase it. Allah would give him more in return. Now, what does it mean when it comes to Allah sending the blessings and salutation? For Allah, it is the mercy, the rahmah, the sakina, which comes down to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's blessed being on his grave, on his wherever he is, with regards to his soul in the alayliyin, with regards to his blessed body in Medina. And angels, when they send salutation, means they support him, they are there to help him out. They are doing the zikr, but also walking about in the land everywhere, and whoever sends salutation, they would take it and bring it to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, that they are sayyahin, and likewise they are men and women, jinns, who would pay a lot of salutation upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is one thing that one should increase as much as possible. The more we do, the more close we come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more beloved we get. It is soothing with its ta'seer, with its effect. And obviously, one cannot do enough of any dhikr, because dhikr or tasbihat are done to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the only form of worship for which there is no limit. Everything else has some sort of limits. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perhaps hasn't asked about any other dhikr to be, any other action to be done other than dhikr in abundance. اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا واذكروا الله كثيرا. It happens that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only specify dhikr, remembrance, with the word abundance. Means you should do that in abundance. It doesn't say in Quran to recite Quran in abundance, to pray in abundance, to do charity in abundance. But it's all been encouraged. Obviously, they're all fantastic actions. They're much more. The reason for dhikr to be done in abundance, including the tasbihat, du'as, and everything else, is so that one does not become negligent of Allah's presence in every action he does. So he is always watchful. So one should be aware of that. And the more the dhikr we do, the more we become acutely aware of that. Anyway, so the durood of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, durood upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is highly recommended and highly meritorious action. Once in the lifetime is wajib, according to some, with this verse. Whereas others would say, every time the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned, it is wajib to say it. Yet others would say every time, even his mention is enough to say durood rather than just his name. So saying Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then still saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Any formula would do, as much as we like, whichever one we prefer. But obviously durood Ibrahimi, the one taught by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, specifically within the prayers, is the most beautiful. Obviously it takes longer. So even a short durood would be fine. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala nabiyyi al-ummi. Ala nabiyyi al-ummi. Allahumma salli ala nabiyyi al-ummi. Any formula would do, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah give us tawfiq to fulfill the wish of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to fulfill the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to fulfill the wish of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for all the Prophet, every second is better than the one before it. And that is what it means. When we continue to make dua, it continues to go higher and higher and higher and higher. And if we are reason for that, means if we, with regards to our dhikr, making it happen, we are coming close to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are actually benefiting ourselves as well. Although it might feel, oh, if this is benefiting Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so what am I getting? Well, you get closeness to Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because this is a sign of love for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The hadith says, "Al-mar'u ma'a man ahab," and whoever someone loves, they do akthara dhikrahu, they increase their mention. They mention them in abundance. The one that you love, you try to talk about him. You find ways to talk about him. mention, make mention of him every so often. So the more we do the durood upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the more we are being in connection and in love with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and hence we will find ourselves being close to Rasulullah. The Sahabi came and he said, "Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if I do not see you once in a day or every so often, I feel like being constricted in my heart. I cannot live like that. But it occurred to me that I realized that in Jannah you'll be at the highest ever level, and yet we'll be quite low down there. But inshallah, how would we see you? If I don't see you, what sort of Jannah would that be?" And then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, "Al-mar'u ma'a man ahab." Man would be with those whom he loves. Whoever he loves, he will be with them. The Sahabi said, that was the best day for us. We were so happy with that, because we knew that we love Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Bakr, Umar, and the likes. So the idea of doing durood is manifold. As I said, to summarize it, to fulfill the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to help Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or support Allah's wish. Obviously Allah doesn't need it, but in doing so, we are pleasing Allah. إِن تَنْصَرُ اللَّهَ يَنْصُرْكُمْ. If you help Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, means helping His works, Allah would help you. So you are actually benefiting yourself by that. And then pleasing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fulfilling His wish and desire, thereby having yourself in close relationship with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and getting your du'as accepted in this dunya. A lot of barakah and blessings would be with you. Angels would be with you, because they keep coming to you to take your durood and bring it back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as the hadith says. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created special angels who would just go out in the earth to those who remember Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, take it from them and give it back to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they present it to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you are doing the dhikr or durood just by standing in front of the grave, the blessed grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the rawda, then you do not need angels to take your durood to him. He can hear it directly from you in the grave. That's why you say salamu, or as-salatu was-salamu alayka ya Rasulullah there, and it's written there even now. Ya as-salamu alaykum ya al-diyar, even for the dwellers of the graveyard. But anyway, we should do that as much as possible, and it is beneficial for everyone, inshallah ta'ala.